Time now, 6:47. You know that bear is still talking over in Judy's office. It just keeps going and going and going. Michael Marsh didn't like it. I sit next to him in the newsroom and...
Now you know why.
I think we have our answer to that. Maybe we should practice throwing him.
We get the perfect spiral on...
Yeah,
there you go.
So how does Brett Favre throw that perfect spiral? And why do Kerry Wood's pitches curve so perfectly?
Our favorite mad scientist and wise guy, Mats Sellén, joins us now to teach us about the physics of sports. Good morning, Mats.
Good morning, Gay.
How are you today?
I'm just fine, thanks. How are you this morning?
I'm doing not too bad.
Did you watch the football games over the weekend?
Yeah, absolutely.
That was kind of bad, wasn't it?
Yeah, they weren't the best games, you know, but it happens.
Yeah, it happens. At least Urbana won down in Mattoon on Friday, so that was very good.
And Champaign Central won, too, I might
add. That's right.
Yeah. This is where our kids go, so that's why we bring these up.
So I thought we could talk a little about football and specifically why you want to throw a spiral. So I'm going to throw a spiral first the right way, maybe, and then I'm going to try to throw one the wrong way. So the right way to throw a spiral is that you get the ball to rotate on its axis. Okay? And the wrong way is to not do that, and it just kind of tumbles. Now, I don't get paid enough to throw a really perfect spiral, but you got the idea there. Now, the idea with a spiral, let me get the ball, is that you want it to rotate on its axis like this, because it will keep going, and it'll keep spinning in the same direction, just like a gyroscope. And if you look over here on the table, I have a gyroscope that I've started, and it has this little spiral pattern on it. And even if I give this a whack with a hammer, it'll wobble a little bit, but it doesn't flop over, okay? And so even if a gust of wind hits a football, it may wobble slightly, but it's not going to flop over. The reason you don't want this thing to flop over is that you want it to go in the very aerodynamic direction where it's pointy, because it's going to have very much less air resistance. Spinning the football also helps the air resistance, it turns out, because you get a layer of turbulence around the ball and you have much less air friction. If I turn off this gyroscope, and now I give this thing a hit, it flops all over the place. So giving this thing a spin makes the football very stable, makes it always point in the same direction, which is the preferred direction to cut through the air, kind of aerodynamically. So that's why they do that.
And it makes it easier to catch if it's coming at you that
Absolutely.
Way, right?
If it's tumbling like that, it's much harder to catch it.
That's true. Well, you know, that's pretty amazing. I never thought about that. I thought it just looked neat.
It all has to do with air resistance, and what we're going to do in the next segment is talk about curveballs, because that also has to do with air resistance in a very slick way. So we're going to show how to chuck a curveball.
Okay, we will take a look at that. Thanks a lot, Mats. We'll be back for more science fun later this morning.
So I guess he's saying you can't really throw the bear. Because it's got the legs and the head.
It's not aerodynamic.
If we wrapped it up in enough tape, we could aerodynamicize it.
Jennifer Roscoe's daughter would not be happy with the bear
we're thinking, that is so fun to give the bear to someone with a small child who will want to go, make the bear talk, Mommy.